By the truth is, today I don't have an intro. I'm Daniel O'Mara. Here is what's in the news.
So, the National Census is back. You know that time of the year when they come around every 10 years or so and count the number of people in a country, goats, cows, celebrities and the like, and then the government decides how many they want to kill off so that the rest of you can survive? But the truth is, what do I know about the census? I mean, I'm like you who's at home right now. All you know about it is counting. So with me in the studio today, I'm going to have a special guest who's here to explain, help us understand exactly what the census is for. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming His Excellency, the President of Uganda. Welcome, Mr. President. I would like to talk to you for a few seconds.
Who are you?
Sir, you don't know me. I'm Daniel O'Mara, the host of this show, Business Unusual.
What do you want here?
The general public and I would like to know more about the census. Yeah, because it's been a while since the last one. I mean, it's ages ago.
Like 12 years ago.
Exactly, Your Excellency. So we all know that it's about counting people and stuff like that. But what we need from you is to shed some light on exactly why a census is necessary.
When Jesus was born, Yusuf.
Yusuf?
The father.
You mean Joseph?
Then.
Okay, the earthly father.
Not the father, but the husband.
Yes, of
Mary.
Luswata.
We are going for a census.
Okay, yeah, that's a touching story and all. But can we bring it back home to Uganda? What is the census for?
Population censuses in Uganda have remained the main source of demographic and socioeconomic information for evidence-based planning and decision-making.
Thank you. Can you please put it in plain English?
It will help government to plan better for its people.
Does that include opposition? Well, I guess not. Okay, so Mr. President, how is the whole census thing aligned with the National ID Registration Project?
A population census looks at groups, where they are, what they are doing, how many there are, but the ID project just looks at you, the individual. Biodata.
What is that?
Biodata means your names, your fingerprints, your face.
Oh, okay. Because there are some people at home who did not know that. Okay, Mr. President, back to the ID project.
The ID project, we just want to know that you don't pretend that you are Kaseija when you are Yoweri Museveni.
Wait. Are you Kaseija?
I am Yoweri Museveni.
Okay, thank you for the clarification. Just so we are clear. So this whole ID thing is about security, majorly.
You can automatically know who stole. In case you never got a loan which you never paid.
How does one even do that?
Well, there are people who like to do that.
Are you one of them, Mr. President?
Whenever I get a loan from those banks, I pay it even ahead of time.
Of course you do. I mean, you are the president.
We now pay for those who don't pay.
Now you're just showing off. Thank you very much for your time, Mr. President. We really do appreciate it. We'll join us again probably next time we have any more questions for you. I'll tweet you for God and my country. So there you have it. That's pretty much what the census is. Counting for future planning.
Counting for planning and improved service delivery.
Okay, maybe I got the slogan wrong. I'm sorry, Mr. President. So when they do come to your home, just know it's for the good of the whole country. Accept to be counted. Don't mistake them for Omeme or National Water. They don't care about your bills. They just want to know how many people are in your house and if they are yours. That's it for Business Unusual tonight. Thank you all and have a great weekend. Stay safe.